Hello, Year Seven. So now you've written the first draft of your stories, and it's time to do a bit of peer editing. You're going to work with both of your partners today, your home partner and your away partner. I've made this video to show you exactly what to do. So the first thing you're going to need is a hard copy of your story. You can also do this if the story is on the computer. You just then have to move around and sit in front of your partner's story. So I have this one here, and it's written by Gayathri. Her name right at the top. She has kindly allowed us to use it today as a model, and she's going to get a house point for that. So here's her copy of the story. Her name, she is the writer, so I'm going to put her name right here. Writer's name, Gayathri. Estimated word count. I'm not quite sure how many words we've got in here. Let's see. We're going to guess that it's 280 words. It doesn't have to be perfect, just a rough idea. Okay. So now I'm going to read through the story. I'll read it aloud. Sometimes reading it aloud is helpful because then you can hear mistakes or things that are a bit awkward. If there's too many people in class or you feel self-conscious reading it aloud, just take your time reading it slowly and silently. The Magical Wand. Long ago, in a far-off land, there was a castle called Gondor. In that castle, there lived two boys named Sam and Frodo. Also living in the castle were Gondol, their personal leader, the princess, the son of Gaston, who had long white hair and had bow and arrows on his back so he can shoot, and most important of all, the king named Philip. Sam was a funny kind of person, but Frodo was a serious person. Sam and Frodo's leader asked them to go on a quest to find a magical wand and destroy it, because the wand has summoned an eye on top of a tower, and now it is controlling the whole kingdom. But they have to be careful, because if any of them touches it, they will be addicted to it, and they can become invisible. So they both set off on a horse to find the wand. As they rode on and on for hours, they finally came upon a dark and grim forest. Sam got really scared, but Frodo was not scared. He was brave and strong. They rode a bit quietly this time, but then they heard a crunch of leaves underneath them. As they looked down, they were relieved because it was only the horse's hooves. As they went down, they rode deeper and deeper into the forest. There were two paths, and they did not know which way to go. As they were about to go, they saw a dark shadow. Swiftly approaching through the gloomy branches was a pitch-black horse carrying a rider cloaked in an inky cape. Okay, so now I'm going to come to this sheet. Gathry's home partner is going to fill in this side. You can see it says home partner right here. The home partner is going to put a tick if Gayathri has done whatever it says here, and a T for target if she needs to work on that bit. And if they want, they can put a comment here in this side. So I'm going to work my way through it. Okay, does Gayathri have a clear beginning, middle, and end? I'm going to put tick and T. Clear beginning and middle. No ending yet because she hasn't finished it. So we know she needs to work on that ending. Okay, does she have 2 to 3 features of Arthurian legends? I think she does. She's got a wand, so that's one. She also has a quest, that's two. And she kind of has a bit of like a magic kind of idea, this idea of like a curse, so that's three. So I'm going to say yes, she meets that one. Is it paragraphed clearly? I can see right now that Gayathri has 4 really nice paragraphs, so they're really nicely spaced and it's easy to read. So I'm going to say yes, she is paragraphed clearly. And her spellings are also mostly correct. So I didn't notice any big ones there. Her punctuation is pretty solid. She's got lots of good full stops. She's got commas and apostrophes. So I'm going to give her a tick for that because it's correct. Later on, we might have to think about whether or not she can vary her punctuation a little bit more. Okay, has she included at least 3 vocabulary words? Let's see. So I spotted quest, so that's one. And I spotted grim, that's two. And then I also spotted, is gloom one of our vocabulary words? I can't remember. She definitely has two. I might have to check on gloom. I think those are the biggest ones. So I'm going to say, check gloom. So I'm going to put target because there's something that needs to happen there. Has she added a twist to make this kind of her own story and a little bit different? I'm not sure. I think this might be a target for her. Not everybody has to have a twist. And you can see all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, everybody has to do those things. These, from add a twist all the way down to used a range of expressive vocabulary, are optional. Depends on whether you're going for a medium or a challenging story, whether or not you have to do those. So I think what I like about Gathry's story is that it has some of those clear elements of an Arthurian legend. But I can tell she's borrowed a few details from, like, the Lord of the Rings. She's still making it into her own story, but I'd like to see maybe a clearer twist on that as well. So maybe she has a new character, or one of the characters is a little bit different, or the action is different. So I think that's a target for Gayathri, is to come up with her own twist. Has she used a variety of sentences? I really like how Gayathri has used brackets here to put in additional information, because that's a different kind of sentence type. She also has a really nice way of starting sentences with as. So as they rode on and on for hours, comma, and she does it as they went down, comma, as I looked down. So she does have a nice way of kind of varying how her sentences begin. So I think that's a good start. And I'm going to give her a tick for that. So the next thing we're looking at is whether or not she's created a detailed setting through imagery. And I'll just remind you that imagery equals the five senses. Now, definitely as we're getting kind of towards the bottom and they're riding through this forest, I begin to notice some description and some imagery about the setting. This idea of the crunch of leaves has sound. And then we have the description of an inky cape and gloomy branches and a dark shadow. That's kind of vision, right? Or sight. But I think she could work on that a little bit more. So I'm going to give a tick and a target. Include more is going to be my comment. I wouldn't mind hearing something about, like, the sound or something along those lines. Okay, has she used any advanced punctuation? Semicolons, colons, and dashes. That is a target. And that's a really complicated thing to do, but that's something she can work on if she wants the challenge. Has she created a dynamic character? A dynamic character is a character who changes. And so far, we haven't really seen that, so I'm going to say that's also a target. Has she used a range of expressive vocabulary? I do quite like some of Gayathri's vocabulary, but there are some things she could probably change. Scared, right? We could come up with maybe a slightly better word for that. What else could we do? We could kind of look up here. It says funny and serious. We could maybe think about those words. Could they become something a little bit more vibrant? So she does have words like inky, which I really like, and gloomy. I like the alliteration here, horse's hooves. I like relieved. So she does have some good vocabulary, but there's a little bit of room for improvement. So again, I'm going to give her a tick and a target. And I'm going to say see boxed words. So she knows those are words to think about. Okay. So now as the home reader, my job is done. I've filled in the sheet and I've given her some really clear feedback. Gayathri then can fill in this bit, writer's response. Based on the feedback above, I'm doing a good job with, and we can see that she's done a really good job with her paragraphing and her spellings and punctuation. Then it says, based on the feedback above, I need to work on, and she can choose two things that she wants to work on. She's got lots of T's here, especially in this more advanced section. She doesn't have to do all of those. She can just think about what are the two most important versions of that that I want to work on. Okay. So once Gayathri's done that, then it's time for her story to go to her away partner. So then I flip it over and it says at the top, away partner feedback. There's your big clue. Okay, and this one is a little bit different. So instead of ticking and doing targets, you're going to just fill in information about the story. So as the away partner, your job is not to make corrections. Your job is just to see, do you understand the story and can you follow what's going on? Okay, so I've read Gayathri's story. And here is what I learned. The main character is named, I think I'm going to say Frodo and Sam, because it's both at the minute. The story is about two friends on a quest to maybe destroy a cursed wand. Okay. One problem the characters have is a threatening rider. That's the person who turns up right where the story finishes. The story takes place in the past, present, future, circle one. I'm not totally sure, but I'm going to say past. And it says, I know this because it says they are riding horses. Now, I could be wrong, but that's my best guess. Okay, I've got a little sword here. It says, I can tell the stories in Arthurian legend because it includes a quest and magic. Okay, one thing I really like about this story is the description of the forest. Okay, one thing I found confusing as a reader was what happens to all the characters mentioned at the beginning. Because we get all those names of those people, but then we haven't really heard about them again, so I'm not quite sure what is going to happen with them. Okay. So that's my feedback as the away partner. I've just filled in some details there about the story. And that's going to let Gayathri know. If, for example, she doesn't think that Frodo and Sam are the main characters, then she knows she has a problem. She needs to go back and fix it so that it's clear who the main characters are. If she thinks that the person hasn't done a good job about what the story is about, again, it might be that Gayathri needs to look at her story and think, maybe it's not very clear what's going on here. So, even if you're not happy with what the away partner has put down here, don't get upset with them. Have a think about, do I need to change my story so that it makes more sense, so that these things are a little bit clearer, and see if that helps. Okay, and then down at the bottom, again, there's a place for Gayathri to respond. It says, writer's response. Based on the feedback above, I'm doing a good job with, and she can put two things she's happy about. Based on the feedback above, I need to work on one, two, three. All right. That's it. So this is how you're going to get some feedback on your story. And once you've done that, you're going to be ready to work on your second draft. Thanks.